Hello, Dissenters! My name is Italics, and I am here today with a game called QBEH-1, the Atlas Cube on the PC. And for my purposes, we're going to call it Cube. It's spelled QBEH, which could easily be something more like Cube, eh? But we're going to call it Cube. And the Atlas Cube is the prequel slash sequel to the first Cube, which I covered on my channel nearly 2 years ago. How crazy is that? And at that time, it was a very, very short free game. And that's how I advertised it as such, so everyone could play it and download it. This, however, is not free. It is going to be released on Steam as of this Thursday, May 15th, I believe, at the price point of $10. And when that is available, of course, I will make a link in the description so that you can go check it out for yourself. Now, this game is going to be much longer than the first free one, hopefully. I haven't beaten it yet. This is very early on. We are in probably the second level of the game, I think, right now. And as you can see, we've been picking up these red building block cubes and using them to help us get to different locations. So that's how things are going to begin. Very nice and easy as they try to teach you the mechanics of the game. You can stack these cubes. So I've got two in my inventory right now, which you can see at the top of the screen. I believe this is a checkpoint in case we fall to our death, which of course we want to avoid. So we're looking at these solid yellow squares and using the red cubes to attach to those. And then of course the red cubes can attach to other red cubes, so I can't place them on this wall, for example, or over here, but here, yes. So that is the basics of the game, but as it progresses, we will get more and more powerful advanced cubes to work with and build with. Okay, where do I go? I thought this would go somewhere, but it has not. I can see through my little peephole. There's some more stuff this way that we have not seen. I think we need to go back, but maybe an easier way to do this is just to jump down onto this carefully placed statue. So that's what we're going to do. And I think we've picked up most of the cubes. We've got four. Did we leave one? I think I left one inside of a plug right over here. So let's capture as many as we can, just in case we need them, and on we go. We've been this direction, we've been this direction, and we started from the left, so now let's head towards this closed door and see where it leads us. Aha! Alright. I'm gonna go grocery shop, but I feel like that's one of those automatic sliding doors. Anyways, some more details about the game that you might be interested in learning. I believe there are 5 worlds that take place in this game, so what I mean is, we're playing on World 1, Level 2. So think something like Mario or something to that effect, with the variety of worlds as you're introduced to new and more powerful cubes that can change gravity or propel you through the air, things of that nature. Right now we're just dealing with the building blocks only. They are going to get more advanced. But see, we're on the first world, which is a giant cube, and as we spin this cube around, we're going to be able to choose which level within that cube we want to go to. So we haven't done level 3 just yet, so let's go ahead and launch on in, get that white glow, and see how the world has changed within the temple. What I like about QBEH-1, the Atlas Cube, so far, is that it is a very peaceful game. It's a game you can just turn on, relax, listen to the breeze, swaying the leaves and the trees, the birds chirping in the distance. It's a very pretty game as well. I like the backdrops. They're suitably high resolution, at least from this distance. And I like the lighting. It's just kind of easy on the eyes, the glowing yellow cubes especially, just giving it that much more ambiance. So we seem to be in a different location now with some floating yellow cubes. I'm not sure that we'll be able to pick those up or not. But you can already tell the difference in the way that the levels are going to start looking. And of course, this is going to start getting harder and harder the further that we progress. I see a yellow block that we can place some more red cubes upon. So goal number one is, of course, to find said cubes and see where we can stack them. Not here, I suspect. All right, third time's a charm. The other two paths were incorrect. I've learned my lesson. Gotta start to the right. Alright, we'll start off by picking up this one. Make some careful jumps back around. Overall, I think that the mechanics are simple enough, but intuitive enough. And responsive, that's the word I was looking for. The jumping is okay, like I don't feel like I'm ever gonna miss. I kinda can gauge very easily how far I can jump. The speed of the runner is good. I like the sound of the footsteps and just how peaceful the game is overall. So that single block should allow us to get over the chasm and onto the other side to find a couple more blocks hiding in the distance. And with those combined, we should be able to make our way back and hopefully use all three which is kind of scary. The jumps are getting a bit more precarious on this middle path. Hopefully, probably bounce them along each other. I see that there are more yellow squares than we have red. Here we find ourselves down the middle path, where I think I'm going to have to do a bit of block juggling. Pick one up and put it onto the other side. Wish I could do like a little jump there. I don't think I can jump that high. Let's try making a little staircase instead. All right, that might work. And back we go. All right. Yep, little block juggling did the trick, but with three, we've done a little bit more of an advanced maneuver, got a checkpoint. So I'm glad to see those checkpoints are fairly prevalent so that you don't accidentally fall down and have to restart the entire course. So that is much appreciated. Definitely not going to be making that jump, so we'll head along the other side, take a little look out, see if we can find anything. There is the portal, which we are trying to get to, and I like, as we are progressing, the more surreal aspect of this. I mean, it's already surreal enough that we're floating on giant blocks with these floating trees in the background to give it a little bit of depth, but I'm liking these floating ones in the distance. It's just making it look a little bit more crazy, which I think crazy would be good. The more plain and boring that these maps become, the worse it's gonna be, so I like the fact that it is getting a little bit more nutty looking. Now, what is that yellow block there for? It looks like there's a secret path up there, but the question is, how do we get to that secret path? There's gotta be a secret area up there, because I just looked through this portway on the way in and found a block hiding in there, so now we've got four to choose from. But how does this work? I can place it over to the side, but not underneath. So I can't make a staircase for myself. Looks like we're gonna need to jump from these little pillars here. Look at this little hidey stair back here, trying to be all incognito. You're not gonna fool me. All right, up we go. And of course we wanna carry these along with us. Making one final jump. What is in here? What are we possibly going to find? Secret-wise, I wonder. This looks like a staircase. And there's, why is the yellow spot over there? I can't jump up. I can't place it underneath me. That would be way too cheaty. Dragging it straight out's not, oh, look at this. All right, we can now make this jump and pick these up along the way. All right, I'm starting to see it now. I'm starting to see the light. Now we've made our way up to the very tip top. We'll be kings of the world up here. I see a floating pyramid. So there are collectibles within the game. It's pretty cool, gives you something to work towards. It just disappeared. To do what? I do not know. But now that we are here, do you think we can make this jump? I don't want to miss, because I don't want to have to redo everything I just did. Do you think I'll die if I fall through this crack? There's one way to find out, guys. Okay, good. No fall damage, at least not that I can see. So we just gotta make a few careful jumps to the end. Having found the collectible, I feel accomplished. And that is the third level. All right, so as I said, there are six levels within the first world. There are about five worlds, so one could rightfully assume, I think, that there are hopefully six levels per world, if I said that correctly. So now that you've seen two of them, you should get an idea on the length of the game itself, whether or not you think it's worth your $10. If you do, again, link will be in the description of this video if you want to buy it for yourself when it releases as of this coming Thursday. As we come to an end here on this video, I want you guys to just remember that we've only seen one block here, since this is the very beginning of the game. There are more blocks and some interesting looking spaces on the ground that I have not seen yet. I just want you to remember that the game does get more advanced. Ooh, shiny. Give me that. I wanted that block. I think I lost it. I think I was supposed to grab it from the air before it flew away from me, and now I have failed, so I'm gonna have to retry this whole level again. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like on the videos that you enjoy. I encourage you to check out QBEH-1, the Atlas Cube, when it does release. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Italics, and I will see you next time.